Hey everyone, welcome. I'm going to show you a very quick tutorial for how we use stock photography and we customize them with our images. So you asked, you receive. So one thing you have to do before you even start this process is you have to get some stock photography. We use Shutterstock and then we look for images that have iPads or Macs or MacBooks and things like that so that we can customize them. You can go to a variety of different places. Hot Chocolate, if you're into the styled stock like the flat lays, Creative Market and Etsy are both really good resources as well. So check those out, grab your stock photography. And then once you do that, now I'm gonna share my screen because most of this is gonna be a screen share. And I'm gonna show you how to grab screen grabs. So this is actually our Marketing Solve, monthly Marketing Solve sales page. I'm sure you guys have all seen it. Now, one thing we have found really awesome is this Fireshot. It is a Chrome plugin and it allows you to capture different sections of a page or capture an entire page. So we've used this for things that are longer, for when we wanted to get like longer images that we can sneak into the different graphics. So then what happens is you can see it does all the work for you. It's really cool. I do it when I want to save a sales page that I see from someone else that I like, or we do it when we're making edits. So you can see, then you get this image that looks just like this. It's pretty cool, right? So that's one cool tip you can start using. Another thing that we do is we'll I'm just going to pull up our program. So let's say I'm going to take a snapshot of this. I use Sketch, which is another add-on. And I just do like a quick screen grab. And that's it. Just hit capture and then it pulls the image and then I can make sure that I get that image and I can use it for the different images, the different stock photography. It's taking a second to load. So while that's loading, there it goes. Let me pull it on the desktop real quick. So while that's loading, you have to use Photoshop. Photoshop is one that I've tried everything in my power to avoid, but it just gives you more functionality and it's really affordable. Now they have like the monthly payment options. I'm using basics. I've never used this before. I'm not an expert here, but this is what I found works the best. So to start embedding that image, right, you can't just place it over there. It's not gonna work. So this is what I do. I'm sure there's other ways, but this is how I learned. You start by just clicking right up here and you get a grid line and you can drag it up and down. So you just drag it to the bottom or the edge of where your image is gonna go. And then this side obviously stops at the top. Then I'm gonna make another one. I'm gonna bring this to the far line and then this one, I'm gonna go right here. So now I've got the image boxed in. Once you have your grid line set, you come over here and you actually draw a box. And I don't know if I already told you, but I'm not a Photoshop expert. I literally saw this tutorial and just went for it. So then you just draw your box over and inside that grid line. So now we have the box. What we wanna do is we wanna come over here, so your little layers panel, and you can, actually let me make this bigger just so you guys can see. You want to right click on it and convert it to a smart object. That allows us to place something inside of it when it's a smart object. So convert it to a smart object, and then we need to transform it. You come up here to your edit bar, you come down here to transform, and then I use distort. And what that does is that allows me to now place these corners to the edge of where I want my photo to go. So I'm gonna go, let's see, like right. And it's not, unfortunately, it's not exact. I haven't figured that part out yet, but we haven't had any complaints so far. So, oops. Lost it. And because all the stock photography has different angles and sometimes it'll be a simple square and it makes it so easy, but sometimes it's a, you know, they're holding things in different angles. And so you have to kind of do this process. So then I hit enter. And once I hit enter, it gives me this option over here to edit the content. So I'm just going to edit the content and it opens up the box. This is the square. So now I need to grab the photo. Let me see if I can find out what I named it just now. Here we go. And I'm going to drag it over there. And that's it. Now I'm just going to, I'm going to pull these. I'm going to hold shift and I'm going to pull these corners And that's it. I'm just going to place it. Okay. So once it's in there, you pull shift, you framed it out, you just hit enter. So that places it. And then you hit save. So command S on a Mac, control S on another computer. And then you go back to your image and voila, you've got your custom content on a stock photo. Works really well. And we use it for Facebook ads. We use it for promos, emails, everything. So I hope you found that helpful. If you guys have questions, you know where to find me. Thank you. See you later.